พี่แสงมณีครับก็แกเป็นมวยประเภทฝีมือครับฝีมือ IQ สูงครับก็เข้าติดตัวแกยากเหมือนกันก็กล้าได้กล้าเสียครับแลกอย่างเดียวครับ
ก็เป็นนักมวยที่เก่งนะครับเก่งคุลามดำมีมันหนักด้วยก็คือนวมมวยไทยเนี่ยคือมันเป็นนวมของ MMA นะครับก็คือมันอันตรายครับถ้าเราประมาทนี่คือแบบร่วงได้รับได้ครับก็คือ
ไฟนี้ก็มั่นใจในพลังหมัดครับว่าถ้าต่อยโดนยังไงก็อยู่ครับก็
คือความไวของเราครับแต่ความหนักของเราอาจจะเป็นรองเขาครับความหนักของเราแต่เราก็จะใช้ความไวเนี่ยผมเชื่อว่าความไวของผมน่าจะได้เปรียบกุหลาบดำนะครับเราก็จะใช้ความไวของเราความคล่องแคล่วความคล่องตัวของเราเนี่ยเข้าไปสู้ครับพยายามหลบลีกพยายามป้องกันให้ดีที่สุดครับเชื่อว่าแบบการเตะการอะไรเนี่ยก็คือแบบเราน่าจะไวกว่าครับเอาจุดตรงนี้ไปสู้
เตรียมตัวไปเต็มที่ครับก็ฝากพี่มาต่อยกันให้สนุกครับต่อยกันให้มันครับเพื่อจะได้ถูกใจแฟนมวยนะครับ
French under 63.5 kilo champion, WPMF European champion, has beaten some great Thai names, including Nopakit, Pharmongkol, Singdan, Katmu 9, and Kontak Sitbunmi. 6-11 record against Thai opponents is Aziz Alali. Go! Nice sweep there from Alali. Go! Just sending an early message to Sangmanee. Sangmanee's southpaw stance. Look out for that left leg power. Many bounds up to his feet. The knock score is a knockdown, of course. It was a sweep. Effective, though, it means that Sangmanee has to pick himself up off the canvas, so it mentally deflates him a little.
He also scores clean techniques, so just like a combination lands, you land a nice right hand or a big kick, it's going to score kind of the same way in the judge's eyes. He goes, Halali's nice and light on his feet, trying to move around. Our stat sheet, it has them dead even at 180 cm, but I think Halali has a little bit of a height and reach advantage.
Overwhelming support for Sangmanee on the one fantasy game. Most playing it on the one super at 89%, a massive 89%, the highest percentage of any contest on tonight's card. Favours Sangmanee for the win over Aziz Halali. Sangmanee left roundhouse kick, trying to force Halali back into that corner. Cracking round kick again, and a good catch and sweep there from Halali. This one at a catch weight tonight. Sangmanee's won titles across so many weight divisions. Rajadamun champion at 108, 112 and 115 pounds. Lumpini champion at 105 and 124 pounds. S1 world champion at 110 pounds. Oh, look at that nice little step across and trying to fire the left hand. Comes in there from Lali, trying to manhandle and bully Sangmanee at the moment. Spinning hook in there from Aziz Lali.
Doing a good job of just mixing up his attacks. He's not giving Sangmanee the same weapon over and over again, so he can start developing his timing. What we've seen from Sangmanee in the past is a gigantic left kick and immediately following in with the left hand. Let's see if Halali can mix things up enough to keep Sangmanee on his back foot. He's pushing forward a lot right now.
This is Muay Thai in 4-ounce gloves. Knees, elbows, all the good stuff. Halali, southpaw stance now for the French Moroccan. Switches back to orthodox. Inside leg kick from Halali. And we go to the towels at the end of one. Look at the beautiful sweep there. Took out the support leg, did Aziz Halali. It's beautiful technique, catch and sweep.
Yeah, that was three beautiful dumps from Halali. He's really mixing up the weapons nicely. Look at that.
And he scored the first round. Some very surprising stuff from Aziz Alali. Maybe you give the first round to the French Moroccan, who opens up with a wicked high-right ground.
Really important in these early rounds. Typically, I've seen Sangmanee start slower in that first round. So if that round went to Aziz Alali, it's a good little way to get on the board and get there early, because now the pressure is going to be on Sangmanee. Now Sangmanee is starting to push forward, getting a little bit more aggressive.
As I said earlier, Sangmanee's never lost to a French opponent. 3-0, including a win over Rafi Bohic, who he beat in Thailand last October. 6-0 overall against European opponents. Looping a right hand there from Aziz Alali. Last time Sangmanee finished an opponent was in December. He TKO'd Martin Avery of Ireland in the second round in Pattaya. Good inside leggy from Alali.
See, Sangmanee thought he was going up top and he started to twitch back. He's looking for that lean back defense, but Alali was starting to go to the leg, touching up twice on that leg kick.
Sangmanee's had some big wins in his time. I say in his time, he's 22 years old, but he's been around for so long. Beating the likes of Pompeya Chikwanda, Super Kanu 9, Muay Thai, PK, Sunshine Muay Thai, Jim. This goes on, good cutting inside leg kick. Sangmanee trying to take out the support leg again.
You see the balance. I think Sangmanee understands what that's coming. He knows how to deflect it properly. With the balance shown by Sangmanee. But I like the mix up of weapons. I'm looking for Alali. He's doing a great job of changing things up in his system.
We spoke about Sangmanee winning that 2012 Sports Writer of the Year award in Thailand. In 2015, Aziz Alali won the Muay Thai TV Awards Fighter of the Year Award. Time there from Sangmanee. Alali inside leg kick. All the accolades that Aziz Alali has beating Sangmanee tonight would be the highlight of the French Moroccan's career. Tries to cure the right hand over the top. Goes back to center ring. On the balls of his feet. The stance of Alali, you could almost envision him in a taekwondo uniform. Drops the hands a little lower, he's very straight up, he's not crouched down, not looking through the brow too much. Sometimes he slips into that taekwondo stance, taekwondo guard. House kick there. Final seconds of the second round of three. Alali's certainly oozing with confidence. And a good performance from him. One more round to go.
You've got the forward pressure coming from Sangmanee, but the artistic display coming from Alali. Just a lot of back and forth action. There it is. See, he's starting to time that high kick. Sangmanee sees it coming. He has a beautiful lean back. I love the strategy. Go!
Nearly died. 2014, Sangmanee, he was poisoned before his match with Thanochai. Southpaw starts with the gold. Alali will switch between Southpaw and Orthodox. A cagey character is the towering French Moroccan.
Beautiful push kicks and defensive strategy coming from Alali. The way he's able to keep Sangmanee away. Sangmanee's always pushing forward. He sees that head kick coming, so I like the strategy of going low to that leg kick from Alali. He usually just muscles people around, especially inside that clinch, throwing people around, ragdolling, if you will. Alali's not giving him an inch.
Nice tap. You see Alali tried to hook the leg and then Sangmanee. Sangmanee said, no, you're going down. Solid left hand there from Sangmanee. Alali moves into the clinch range. Some knees here from Sangmanee, trying to fold him in half like origami. Alali turns him against the ropes, chance for the elbows. It's a knee again from Sangmanee. These will score well for the tie.
Look how he's putting those hips into that. He just drives that knee right into the midsection of Alali. Scoring a lot of points with these knees right now.
Sangmanee, who comes in having won his last five between May and October this year, all by decision. is he 90 seconds away from another decision win, a one super series debut. And there again, the taekwondo stylings of Aziz Alali. You see it quite clearly. Very much WTF taekwondo, the type of taekwondo you see in the Olympic Games. Quick shuffles, low hands. This is not a clear-cut decision by any stretch of the imagination, folks. I'm telling you now. You could not tell me clearly at the moment who has won this one, who is winning this one. It could go either way. Three judges are ringside. Scoring on a 10-point must system as Alali hands up. Elbow and then throws a spinning hook in. More of that taekwondo style coming in from Aziz Alali.
But it eats up a little bit of time too, getting back up off the canvas like that. Ate up about 7 seconds. Alali needs each of these seconds to score points, because look at this aggression coming from Sangmanee. He's trying to score a lot of points with his forward pressure.
Referee Onari needs to remove the project armband off the left arm of Sangmanee. It's come loose, it's around his wrist. Doesn't see it though on his blind side. Sangmanee, left roundhouse kick. Final 10 seconds of the round of the contest. It looks like we're going down to the judges. Aziz Alali puts the fist up, he believes he's won it. Final flush of roundhouse kicks. Alali draws a short straw. We are going down to the judges.
I don't know, man. You can't let your opponent off the hook, even when you believe in your heart of hearts that you won that match. You have to utilize every single precious second you have.
Let me tell you where it comes from, though. In the stadiums in Thailand, in the final 30 seconds, even the, sometimes the final minute, the guys will take the foot off the steam, take the foot off the pedal, and back off each other and dance around the ring.
In favor of your winner, by unanimous decision, from the red corner, Sangmanee.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.